Hey Cloud Gamers, today I'm having a look at the lesser known PS Now PC client, which allows you to stream PlayStation games on the PC. So here are the specs. It says you need 5 megabits per second download, so your PlayStation account and a DualShock 4 wireless controller. So having a look at the games here, it does specify that they have a 720, 1080 or 1080p output. This is looking at the Spider-Man, which is one of the PlayStation exclusives. But when we look at each of the games, if we look in a bit more detail, it does actually specify that any PS Now games are streamed at a max 720p, which is a bit of a letdown on the PC client, to be honest, considering most of us run at 1920 by 1080 minimum, with much more people starting to use 1440 or 4K monitors. There is an impressive collection of games on PS Now, ranging from some newer titles all the way back to some classic PS2. However, the interface is not very user-friendly. You have to use these little arrows scrolling left and right. There's lots of genre repetition of games as we scroll down, and definitely not PC-friendly. There's no search, which is a major drawback when you're trying to find games. So looking at the settings, there is really not a lot you can do. It's capped at 720p. You can access your account information and that's about it. So as we dive into have a look at Shadow of the Tomb Raider here, I've sped up the start here because it does take a fair amount of time. Do also have to have that DualShock 4 controller, as I don't have one on PC. I've had to use the Stadia controller there. But Shadow of the Tomb Raider also locked up on me at the start. So if we dive into some gameplay with Just Cause 4, we'll see how PS Now actually performs. So the first time I ran this, I did have some kind of graphic glitches where the settings kind of got locked at 360. But after a restart, I was able to run it full screen, and you can see that kind of 720 connection.
That looks like the place.
It doesn't look too bad considering. Just Cause 4 is a fairly old game.
Never seen anything like Yapa before.
It's now free. That's one of the reasons I had a look at this.
Might be right.
At the town here, and then I'm going to go into a cutscene to see the best graphics that it can output. So moving into the cutscene, just a small portion of it so we can see the quality here. Definitely tell that it's a 720 stream. Obviously the PlayStation isn't as rich as PC games. Still, it plays quite well, and if you don't mind that slower quality, then you do have a good library of PlayStation games to choose from. One of the surprises is Control is actually on PS Now till August. Being a newer, more graphical intense game, I thought I'd have a look. You can again tell that 720p stream. If you've looked at any of the PC gameplay, especially with the ray tracing enabled, this is nowhere near close. But considering you can play Control as part of the PS Now subscription, which is free for 7 days, and then £8 a month in the UK, you get some bundle deals. Again, the quality is pretty good. It plays very well.
You can't let this happen. You can't let this happen.
Control is a very different game. I'm actually quite enjoying it, and even though it's lower quality, being able to play it without the £50 price tag is quite a bonus.
That was
There we have it. That's gameplay and overview of PS Now. Is it a contender in the cloud gaming industry right now? I don't think so, and I don't think Sony are really trying that hard. It's another way of people being able to play some of the PlayStation games when they're away from their PlayStation console. Console is definitely their main port of call right now. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with the latest cloud gaming news.